So, it's the big one, and the question on everyone's lips is who is going to be champions. We'll be finding out soon enough. The final gets underway in just a few moments. I'm John Champion, and covering this game alongside me, someone who certainly knows a thing or two about playing at the top level, it's Jim Begley.
Hi John, it's been a great buzz here since I sat in my seat. I think this promises something special today.
Everyone, please welcome the two eyes.
And now,
an interesting fixture in prospect then. Naturally, hopes and expectations are high.
Yes, I've been a winning finalist and I've been a losing finalist, and I don't need to tell anyone what I prefer. Winning will help fans remember you for a long, long time. So I sincerely wish both teams well. I hope that all the players can give a good account of themselves and, you've heard it before, may the best team win. Plays a big part in the opening stages, but an early goal can blow all that away, so I hope that we can...
It's Alexis Sanchez! There was very little backlift there. Goalkeeper reacted well.
Alexis Sanchez almost put a side ahead with a pretty fierce attempt. He really spanked that.
Decides to shoot. A scintillating goal.
Listen, the big names earn their reputations for precisely the reason we've just seen. They have a habit of making their presence felt. Here we are, early stages. He struck one and he looks hungry for more. And looking back at that, that's how you play on the counter. Quick and decisive and ruthless with the finish. I thought it was a stunning, stunning breakaway.
Are the first to strike.
I look, from experience, I can tell you that the first goal is always vital in any final. It can make such a psychological difference.
Knocks it through. Strikes it. Oh, that's a goal to remember forever.
Oh, that was a cracking little exchange to set up the finish, and a lovely understanding between both players. I mean, that's clearly tailored on the training ground and delivered beautifully on match day.
Number 9, Alvaro Morata.
Juventus resume with the scores back level.
Well, I think the players will be buoyed by the fact that they've managed to level things in a hurry. Tails most definitely up now.
An important interception. Things were starting to look dangerous. Melo looking to exploit the space. Who can latch onto that? A much needed intervention that was too. Cuadrado switches play to the other side. He's free through the middle. Oh, that's clever. Possibility for a shot. Got a good hold of that.
Well, the last line of defence came to the rescue when the lines in front weren't looking too clever. Good stop.
Cuadrado, forward it goes, looking to exploit the space. Midway through this first half, play has settled into a nice pattern. Cleared away from immediate danger. Knocks it through. No, needed a better ball there. Cuadrado. Who can latch onto that? They got a throw in. Driven in.
Paulo Dybala, usually, is so good from that range. He didn't quite connect as he can, though.
And that's not getting through.
The ball crossed the line.
Clever ball from him.
Cuadrado.
He's going on.
That's good defending.
It's through.
Martinez.
Maybe his technique a little lacking there.
Well, credit to him for trying, although he just didn't quite get the touch right.
There will be 1 minute added time.
Perisic. Kicks it a long way. There's the whistle. Entertaining first half that has simply flown by. So, nothing to separate the two teams. It stands at one apiece. Any thoughts on what the first 45 minutes of this final has thrown up?
Look, this is highly entertaining and exactly what we were hoping for. Goals at both ends and what looks like two very evenly matched sides. Bring on the second half.
Tight old game this, 1-1. Yeah. So we're underway.
Inter playing well with lots of opportunities and plenty positives to take from the first half. Despite this scoreline, converting chances would make a world of difference for them.
Nice bit of trickery. Hits it. It's a fine save. Alexis Sanchez. He'll be penalised for that. No surprise, it's a yellow card. Alexandro, Melo, Morata, it's played into space, and that's been cleared. He's going after it. And the whistle's gone, but it's for a foul. The referee just wants to have a word with him by the looks of it, probably about keeping his composure and his temper in check.
It's about time we've seen something different. They've looked to play that longer ball, you know, over the top, down through the middle, and mix their game up a bit more. I think they may just get someone in behind that defence now.
Possibility here for a shot. Goal for Inter. This really is quite unbelievable. They now lead by one goal. Chiellini. He shoots there. A fine stop by the keeper.
Well, he generated the power and let the ball take on a mind of its own after that.
Has it back now. Yes, referee's given it. He could be in trouble here. Referee's having a word with him, but it's only a warning. He needs to be careful, though, with his tackling.
Yeah, and as their most significant attacker, he isn't about to receive any generous invitations.
Try, but no goal.
His reputation is better than what we've just seen.
And the referee has blown now. The advantage didn't really rack up, and it's going to be a yellow card too. Perisic. Martinez has got it. Cuts out what was really a sloppy pass. They break away, and this is promising.
knocks it through. We've got another throw in.
Space on the flank.
Juventus showing a little more urgency now, and to be honest, this is what's required.
It's not like they have any choice but to just pile forward in numbers, Jim, really.
Spotted.
He takes the opportunity to shoot.
Taken with some style.
It's a comfortable lead now, 2 goals. A well-placed lob.
Oh, that was great to watch. It had to be an instant decision to lob the ball, and it just paid off perfectly. What a goal.
Looks like a change is in order. There's a player there waiting to come on. He's being withdrawn and his contribution isn't going unnoticed.
I think he's put in a good shift, and their fans appreciate that. I think he can feel pretty happy with the contribution he's made.
Substitution for Inter
now lead by two.
The crowd are calling for this to be put to bed. There's little sympathy about.
Number nine, Ellen Jekyll.
Skillfully hit. He really should have put that away.
And maybe they're just feeling the pressure and trying a little too hard. You know, if the manager could calm them down more, I think they'll fare better.
Like a change is in order. It's a player there waiting to come on.
Coming on to replace him is number 22.
Hit it away. That will be a throw-in. Quite a scrappy spell, this. Martinez has got it. Incisive pass, that. Coming to go it alone for now. Plays it clear. There are only 5 minutes to go in this game. And he'll shoot here. But in football terms, nearly is nowhere.
Well, if he hopes to do better than that, he's got to work on his technique and his timing. The contact wasn't right there, so there wasn't much chance of success.
Substitution.
There's plenty of activity down by the touchline. Looks like we're going to get a substitution.
Coming on the field is
Cuadrado. Martinez.
Down the middle it goes, hits the ball. Another goal. They have a 3-goal advantage, and that should be enough.
And as soon as they made that error in midfield, they didn't have time to react before the ball hit the net. Very much a lesson learned.
The goal scored for Inter. Number 9.
So, could this be the one that settles it? Melo.
There will be 5 minutes added time.
Alexandro. Hooper to the right. Forward it goes. Through the middle it goes. On his own, drives it in. Oh, that was a really good position. Chiellini. There is the final whistle. Inter have done it here. The trophy will get one final polish before the presentation, but it is a glittering prize. They have won the Konami Cup, and there are tears of joy. Well, moments like this will live forever in the memories of the fans, the players, the coaching staff, and the manager. Unforgettable highs and lows along the way, and at long last, they've been crowned as champions.